sees you out of your disguise, he's going to know you're the stalker.
Ethan's not going to see me, Whitney.
And what about the private investigator?
You mean your boyfriend, Frank?
For the last time, Teresa, I do not have a thing for Frank Lomax.
Right, like I don't have a thing for Ethan. But it doesn't matter whether we do or don't. Frank's off the case, and Ethan thinks his stalker is living with her parents in South America.
You know, I'm beginning to think that you enjoy lying.
Besides, if Ethan saw me out of my disguise, he'd realize what I was really like. Maybe he wouldn't get mad at me. Maybe I'd get a completely different reaction from him.
Where have you been all my life?
I've been right here, Ethan, waiting for you. It could happen, Whitney. Ethan could see the real me and forget to be mad.
You're dreaming, Teresa. If Ethan puts it together that his mother's plain Jane secretary is one and the same as his stalker, it's orange jumpsuit time for the both of us in the Harmony Jail.
A long time to powder their noses, but this has got to be a new world record.
You cannot possibly think that you're still going to have a future with Ethan.
I can still fantasize about him, can't I?
It's your fantasies that got us mixed up in this in the first place, Teresa.
You're just mad because I made you lie to that dreamy private detective.
Yes, I am mad that you dragged me into your world of craziness. But the person you're hurting most of all is yourself.
Don't worry about me.
Come on, Teresa. I have known you since the second grade. And I know that once you get an idea in your head, no matter how far out it is, you do not give it up.
Maybe I've learned how to let go.
Since when? I mean, I am talking to the girl who was so obsessed that she wallpapered her entire room with photographs of Ethan Crane and his family.
I took them down.
The pictures on the wall, but the pictures in your mind are still there.
That's because I never got my chance with them. Things would be so different if I hadn't caused any of those accidents.
But you did, Teresa. They happened, and you can't take them back. You've got to just cut your losses, forget about Ethan, and move on.
But Whitney, Teresa,
listen, you are going to have a fantastic life with a guy that is better for you than Ethan, a guy that wants you for you. He's out there somewhere, just waiting.
I'm certainly not going to find him looking like this. That's better.
You won't have to pretend forever, Teresa. We're both going to find someone.
And you already did, Whitney.
Don't even start in with me with Frank Lomax again.
Don't you think he really did like me?
Definitely.
But if you think Ethan's bad news for me, that guy is definitely even worse news for you. Come on, let's get going.
Wait, now what?
I just need to brush my hair. It won't take a minute. I shouldn't have teased you about Frank the PI. The last thing we need is to run into him again.
Don't worry, Teresa. I mean, Ethan took him off the case. I'm sure he's long gone from Harmony by now.
How do I look?
Much different than you did when you first came in here. Now, let me just check and make sure there's nobody outside, okay?
You are such a worrywart, like someone's out there looking for us.
It's safe. There's nobody out there but some kids. Come on. Are you ready yet?
Yes.
Okay.
Let's go.
Not this way, that way. I want to walk through town and do some window shopping on the way home.
All right.
Hey, Teresa, let me see your brush. I want to put my hair up really quick.
Shoot. I left it in the ladies' room down at the harbor.
Hey, sis. Whitney.
Hey. Hey, guys. How's it going?
Nice to see you again, Charity. How you doing?
I'm okay.
I'm going to run Charity home on my bike before it gets dark.
Did you ever find that person you were looking for?
Yes and no.
Oh, Charity spotted her mom's sister here in Harmony, but the woman disappeared before she could get to her.
Wow, at least you saw her. That means you don't have to move, right?
You'll absolutely love it here. I mean, me and Teresa will introduce you to everybody who's anybody.
That's right. What?
Charity might have to move after all.
But I...
It's a complicated situation.
Would you all excuse us for a second? Gil, if you really like this girl, you have to find a way to keep her in your life.
Tell me about it.
You've got to do whatever it takes. And if that doesn't work, you have to do more. I know what it's like to love someone with all your heart and then lose them. It hurts, Miguel.
You're talking about you and Ethan, aren't you? It's okay, Teresa. I'm not Louise. I'm not going to yell at you.
It's unbearable.
I can't imagine what it must be like for you to be around Ethan every day in disguise, knowing you can't be with him.
That's why I don't want you to give up on Charity. At least one of us should get the chance to be happy. Believe it or not, my life's been pretty complicated. But I managed to avoid disaster today, and you will too, Charity.
And if Teresa can do it, anybody can.
Right. I'd do anything to make it happen. Harmony already feels like home.
Well, then it will be. You'll see.
And don't forget to say goodbye to us before you leave.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye. See you later.